Welcome to the dotCMS training video, an overview of the dotCMS platform. Once you get logged into the dotCMS system, you will see a screen that looks very similar to this one, with access to pages, access to content, and access to help. In the help menu, you will have access to documentation or tutorials, help and frequently asked questions, videos will also be training related, and then accessibility, which walks you through some of what you need to know about making your website content accessible. Now, dotCMS recognizes a difference between pages and the content that goes on those pages, hence the two options here for making a selection. Now, in pages, you're going to select for browser, and this will actually show you what folder or folders you have access to in dotCMS based on your level of permission. Now, when you click into one of those folders, like the demo folder, you will see a series of subfolders and content within your main folder. Now, how this translates over onto the public side of your site is this top level navigation on your site. So, for example, you'll see that there is a widgets menu, and in the back end, there is a widgets folder. Now, a note on top-level navigation and pages on your site. Not all menus require a folder in the back end. If you only have a one-page menu on your website, you can save that page within your main folder. The folders that have been created in the back end are for menus that have multiple subpages. There's also a folder called Uploads, which will include a folder for files and a folder for images. And this will be a place that you will be able to upload the images and files that you will use on your website. And this will help to make your main folder clean so that it's only housing those pages that are showing on your site. Now, content is where you're going to search and or create some of the content that's going to go on your site. For example, when you click on content and search, it will bring you to the dotCMS dashboard where you can select for things like article, digital document, event, person, that kind of thing. And then you can either edit or create new content. And this will help you get started with editing your website.